You also have this exclusive audio between Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, and Tulsi Gabbard for what took place in South Carolina.
So yesterday spoke with Tina. Tina and I were covering, you know, we were doing like little voices. We were trying to see what people would come up with what they were saying. And you what they were actually saying was very, very bland compared to what people were thinking. So, Johnny, you have it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So she actually said, and I edited it below on the subtweet, that's the handshake heard around the world is what she said. Yeah. And there was a couple things in there that were kind of hard
Bernie
to hear.
And then Bernie said after that, and you're the one that, what was it?
It's kind of hard to hear. We just put the main points, but.
Can we play it again?
Yeah. What did he say?
You just approved it. He said you just approved it.
Yeah. So it's kind of funny because a lot of people were like, "Oh, Tulsi's brokering peace." So now the world, like, this is exactly what she would do if she was like Secretary of State or involved as VP, and people were loving it. I'm like, yeah. I mean, she is like the peace person, like that's like, okay, aloha. And same thing with Bernie. I mean, that's what I love about him, and that's what I love about her. But God damn it,
what is it?
I hate that they speak well of Obama, that they still speak well of Joe Biden. I mean, that irritates the hell out of me. We have to separate ourselves from these corrupt Democratic candidates, and don't be mad at us if we do it for you, if you refuse to do it, because that's why we're here.
Well, yeah, that is why we're here. But I can just see what was going on in the pew. What is it, Tulsi? You should really, you know, shake Elizabeth's hand. All right, Tulsi, I'll do it for you. If you approve, we'll do it. All right, let's talk about this, because everybody wants to talk about
it. It's like he didn't want to do it, though.
You know, but
it's like he didn't want to do it. He was like, here, let's just do this
because
so people want us to do it.
It's so on par for Bernie is, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And once again, like when I was saying, and I was saying to you, you know, that's just like Bernie Sanders to say, stop paying attention to the hoopla. We got to be talking about the issues.
They agree on that.
Yeah, absolutely. Like
climate change.
Climate change.
We should be talking about climate change instead of this handshake.
Yeah.
And, you know.
Forgive and forget, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, no, I mean, I think what he means, it's not going to change what happened, though. That's the thing I want to emphasize.
Well,
it doesn't change the fact that Elizabeth Warren stabbed him in the back. It doesn't change the fact that Joe Biden is corrupt. It doesn't change any of that. But what he's saying is, we know this. Let's stop drawing attention to it right here and now. Let's shake hands because the people want that. Like, the Democratic establishment is like, oh, Bernie's not talking to Elizabeth Warren. That's all they're making it a gossip column. What's at the root of it isn't gossip. It's corruption. It's the differences in policy between Elizabeth Warren, Joe Biden, and Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
Those are the things that matter, because the differences in policies affect me, affect you, affect all of us.
Yeah.
So we need to separate what we're talking about here, because I agree that the media likes to run off and be TMZ and
all
just
the
like
time.
But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the policy differences.
Yeah.
And we need to make sure we're separating that from some sort of low blow attack against any of these candidates.
Right. Yeah. Right.